everyone. Welcome back. Are you ready for another lesson today? Another exciting story? Some craft time? Well, let's look in our gift bag here to see what our story is about. It's kind of heavy today. What could be in here? What is this? Oh, it is heavy. Do you see what this is? It's a rock, a large rock. In our story today, Joshua wanted the people to remember all that God had done for them and to remember to love God and obey his commands. He took a large rock and he put it beside a tree. Do you see some more rocks around here? How did so many rocks get on my desk? Help me. And if you're in your classroom, you're probably going to have to find some too. Let's find all the rocks we can and get them picked up. Do you see any more? Oh, here's one up here. I don't know how these rocks got all over the place. Rocks in our story. Ugh. There, we got rid of those. So we remember God is always so good to us. He has blessed us in so many ways. He's given us family, place to live. We get pizza puppies. We get so many things. And we need to remember all the things God has done for us. And in our story, Joshua wanted the people to remember everything God had done for them. So let's get started. Are you ready with your listening ears on? Comfortable? Ready to pay attention and learn? Might even have some questions. You never know. Here we go. Joshua challenged the people. So Joshua was getting old. For many years, God had given the people of Israel peace and rest from their enemies. They had not fought any battles. I bet that was so nice. One day, Joshua gathered all the Israelites. He had some important things to tell them. Joshua said, "Remember what God has done for you. When you were in battle, God fought for you. I want you to be strong. Be strong. Do everything God told you to do. Do not disobey God. Do not turn away from God. Trust him." Joshua said, "God has never broken a promise to you." Then Joshua reminded the people of everything God had done for them in the past. God had called Abraham and given him a son, Isaac. Then God had given Isaac two sons, Jacob and Esau. God had rescued the Israelites from the Egyptians. God had done so many great things for them. Joshua said to his people, "Will you worship God or false gods? As for me and my family, we will worship the Lord." The people replied, "We will not worship other gods. We know how much God has done for us, and we love him." The people remembered that God had helped them win battles against their enemies. They remembered how he protected them as they traveled. So how were they going to remember it? They took this giant rock, bigger than this, put it by the tree. Every time they saw it, they would say, "Do you remember all the wonderful things God has done for us? So many things." Here's a few of the stories. Do you remember when the people were escaping from Egypt and they had to cross the Red Sea? God opened it up and they got to go through on dry land. He kept protecting them then. Then they're wandering in the wilderness. They're crying because they're so hungry. God provided manna and quail so they would have something to eat every day. And they were so thirsty, God told Moses to hit the rock. Water came out of the rock and they had something to drink. Then, when they are getting closer to the promised land, the last thing they had to do is cross that Jordan River. The priest had to step into it before it would open. And one side of it just opened up and they were able to go right through and God kept them safe. The story we had recently was the story of when they got to Jericho. The people marched around the city. Remember? Six times, once a day. They marched around one time for six days. And on the seventh day, they marched around seven times. They shouted. They blew the trumpets. And what happened? Down came the walls. God helped them many times to defeat their enemies. And they've been living in peace for a long time now, which was so great. So Joshua gathered them together. There's Joshua. And he said, "I just want you to remember all the things God has done for you." And we need to do that too. God has done so many wonderful things for us. God loves us so much. What is our Bible passage again? Our Bible passage says, God shows his strength to people. He does. And all those stories, we saw how God showed his strength. So how can we remember some of the good things we have? What about if we do something with about our family? If you're in class today, you're going to get a house picture. It's kind of a little house. So you're going to draw your family inside. You also get some construction paper, and you can tear that into pieces and decorate, make your house how you want to make it. So how are you going to do it? What are you going to do for your house? How many people are in your family? Is there a mom and dad and kids? Is there a mom and grandma and kids? Are there one child, lots of kids? Families are all different. We can just draw people like stick people, or we can make them super fancy. Some of you are great drawers. We can make, and some of you, like in my house, I'm the Nana and I have two grandsons, almost three, that live with us. I'm just drawing myself right now and my two grandsons, Levi and Chase. There's more in my house, but for right now, I'm just drawing myself and Levi and Chase. I'm not a very good drawer, but you get the idea. Okay, so I have that in my house, but I want to make my house a little bit more fancy because it looks kind of boring. So if I wanted to put something on the roof, remember how I told you how easy you can tear this paper? If you tear it the right way, that is. Construction paper only tears well in one direction. So we can make some scraps. This time I'm going to use the glue stick. I'm going to fill in my roof. It's a very pointy roof. Some places where people live, the roofs are flat. In Bible days, the roofs were flat. When I used to live in Mexico, our house had a flat roof also. So people could be walking up on your roof. You couldn't do that with this pointy roof. So you can just take your paper and put it how you want it to make your roof if you want to. Then I think I'll make some grass too. What is that? How does that sound? Grass. You can have grass or trees or flower plants. This can be like a grassy yard. Do you like to play outside? Isn't playing outside wonderful? That's what God wants you to do. Get outside, enjoy that fresh air, run and play, ride bikes. Who knows how to ride a bike? I love riding my bike. Well, this gives you an idea. What do you think about that? It's in grass. I have my house, and it helps me to remember God has blessed me in so many ways, and God has blessed you too. So let's make our houses, make our families, tell them all about it. Have fun tearing up paper, or maybe you could use scissors. Anybody that knows how to use scissors and just cut it up. Our missionary family we're still talking about, so you don't forget about them. The Worthy family that have four children, and they moved to Italy to tell people there about Jesus. Italy, the country of Italy, is across the Atlantic Ocean, and it looks like a boot. But people there speak Italian. They need to know about Jesus also. So you could tell people, you could tell your friends about Jesus. So thank you for joining me today. Come back again. Pay attention in your class. Have a great day today. And remember, Jesus loves you. Until next time.
Now, family, may the Lord bless you and protect you. May his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May he look on you with favor and give you his sweet peace. You are loved.